Hello, my lovelies. Welcome to my channel. Here we are doing the monthly reading for all zodiac signs. This is going to be for Aquarius, Sun, Moon, and Rising. I want to wish you guys a very prosperous, very successful, and abundant 2018. Remember, intentions is everything, so make sure to put your intentions out there and let spirit and the universe know exactly what it is that you want, okay? Alrighty, let's see what spirit has for my Aquarians out there. Aquarius for January 2018. Is it me or does it still feel so weird saying 2018? It always happens to me the beginning of each single year. Kind of have to stop there and question, are we really in 2018? Yes, we are. Alrighty. Let's see. Aquarius, January 2018. What are the messages? Also, if you guys are interested in private consultations, definitely look at the description box below. You'll be able to find my contact information on there. Aquarius. Okay. Let's see what spirit has for you guys for January. Okay. First card is the Six of Cups, the Hierophant, the Six of Pentacles, the Eight of Cups, the Ten of Pentacles, the High Priestess, the Knight of Wands, the Ten of Swords, the Two of Pentacles, and the Queen of Pentacles. General energies for the month. You have the Eight of Pentacles. Okay, Aquarius. The Eight of Pentacles is definitely putting the effort or willing to put the effort towards wanting to achieve a goal. Usually represents pretty much putting your nose to the grindstone, and you're very focused and very determined for the month of January. This could be residue energy from December, but it's almost like you're putting your intentions or setting out intentions of what you're wanting to accomplish or achieve with the Eight of Pentacles. I do see a lot of you guys working late or studying, putting effort to get knowledge or get wisdom about a specific subject for most of you guys. This could have to do with the fact that Saturn is going into your 12th house, so it could be the need. You're going to start to have this need to want to get information or reading or anything that has to do with higher learning. I definitely do see that happening for you guys for the month of January. Now let's get into your reading. You have the Six of Cups here. The Six of Cups is looking towards the past in a very nostalgic way. Perhaps some of you guys could have to do with missing a person or a family member that recently passed away, or that passed away for a while now, but it's almost like the tapping into reminiscing type of energy. You do have the Hierophant here, and the Hierophant is definitely talking about, again, higher learning, going within, and anything that has to do with spirituality. I do see you guys very proactive in getting that type of information or that type of knowledge. You do have the Six of Pentacles here, the Charity card. The Charity card next to the Hierophant. I feel that for a lot of you Aquarius for the month of January, you're going to be sharing or communicating either with friends or someone that you trust in reference to learning some type of craft or studying some type of religion, or going to a person that is very wise in reference to getting guidance, to get clarity in regards to anything that has to do with the metaphysical or spiritual world. You have the Eight of Cups here, and the Eight of Cups next to the Six of Pentacles is definitely, for some of you guys currently have either walked away from a relationship where you felt that it was only you, the one that was putting the effort, or it could have been that they were the ones that were putting the effort and you decided or got to a point of decision of not wanting to move forward or not being able to give to them what they were expecting, which was probably having to do with either marriage or moving in with one another. Now, the Ten of Pentacles is here, and I see that for a lot of you guys, this path of learning, whatever it could be, that has to do with learning or getting some type of knowledge, hidden knowledge even, for some of you guys. Pay very close attention to your intuition. You do have the High Priestess here and the Hierophant. Hierophant is all to do with spirituality, but it also speaks about, has to do with, again, like I said, things that are not very prone for Aquarians. So if we're talking about relationships, this has to do with marriage and commitment. And again, Aquarius have this need to have freedom or feel that they have the freedom, even in a relationship. And the High Priestess here is definitely talking about, again, hidden knowledge. So I feel that a lot of you guys are going to be looking into the law of attraction, how to manifest things, or anything to do, again, like I said, with spirituality, maybe studying a different religion, anything like that. Now, the Ten of Pentacles, again, like I said, is calling to me very strongly with the Six of Cups. And again, this is having to do something. There is something in the month of January that is going to pull you towards your childhood or a remembrance of your childhood and almost understanding why you have the belief system that you currently have. Or perhaps some of you guys are going to be questioning the belief systems that you were taught. It's almost like trying to find your true self, trying to find what you truly, genuinely believe in. And the High Priestess is here to tell you, listen to your intuition, you will be guided. Know and understand that. Now, you do have the Knight of Wands here. And again, I do see communication coming forth from a person from the past. This could have been for those of you guys that recently broke up or recently separated from your partner. I definitely do see them coming back around the second week of January, trying to communicate with you and trying to see if there's a possibility to be able to fix this or put some type of reconciliation on the table. But I do see the Ten of Swords here, and the Ten of Swords is definitely talking about ending a cycle. So again, we are in January, so there's a lot of endings, but also the positive is with endings, there comes new beginnings, okay? You have the Two of Pentacles. Make sure to ground yourself. Make sure to find whatever it is that you're passionate about and be able to pursue it, not in a fearful way, but be open and surrender to the possibilities. The Two of Pentacles can represent having to juggle between work and the family dynamic or children, if you do have children, especially if you're a single mother or a single father. Knowing and understanding that sometimes, even if, you know, if you do have children and the children are, you know, adults, sometimes it is necessary for us not to be so smothering to them or be, you know, what's the word? You have to allow them to grow. And sometimes it's not a positive thing when we overdo things for our kids, even if they get to adulthood, because they become self-dependent on you. And that's not a good thing. So try the best you can to allow them to learn, to allow them to grow. And again, try the best you can if you are dealing with a child or your child, but is an adult and they are either asking you for money in the month of January, and it has something to do with them putting themselves in that position. Try the best you can not to, you know, pretty much be the savior. They have to learn their lesson and they have to understand that sometimes it is necessary for us to be a little bit harsh on them, because it creates character, okay? So just know and understand that. Now, you do have the Queen of Pentacles here right at the bottom of the reading. So I feel that for a lot of you guys, if you guys have been looking for stability, stability starts to come in January. I want to say the second week of January. Nonetheless, make sure not to be overspending or to overindulge in anything. The Queen of Pentacles is a very grounded energy. So know and understand that it is necessary for you to be grounded. If you feel a little bit out of whack, if you don't feel like yourself just yet, again, like I said, with the shift of Saturn going into your 12th house, has everything to do with the hidden, has everything to do with secrets and religion or spirituality. So the best way for you to be grounded is either through meditation or try to make some type of grounding with the element of air. You know, the best way I can say it is, for some of you guys may want to burn a little bit of sage, you know, put it in a bowl or in a glass, burn the sage, walk around it in a clockwise position 7 times. And then on the 7th time, walk through it, like jump over it, And ask the element of air to assist you. It is your prominent element to ground you to be able to have clarity and insight. Okay? So I hope you guys enjoyed this reading. I do want to mention for some of you guys may be going with an earth sign or to an earth sign, which would be a Taurus, Capricorn, or Virgo, getting some type of spiritual guidance or getting some type of insight in regards to something that they've learned to master. Know and understand that if you are dealing with an earth sign and you go to them for advice, know and understand that you can genuinely trust them because they are giving the advices to the best of your interest, okay? So I hope you guys enjoyed this reading. Light and love to all of you guys. And again, like I said, I wish you guys prosperity and abundance for this 2018. We will see each other in the middle of the month, okay? Bye.